Arkansas Governor Sarah Huckabee Sanders has found herself embroiled in yet another scandal. Now, keep in mind, Sarah Huckabee Sanders has been in office for roughly 14 months. And already, in those 14 months, she has had multiple different scandals, all related to her spending and her travel, which her travel, of course, is now barred from being requested via a Freedom of Information Act request, thanks to a law that Huckabee Sanders herself signed. And that's where the new problem comes in. You see, a couple weeks ago, Sarah Huckabee Sanders decided to take her entire family, herself, her husband, and three children, to the Super Bowl. Now, there's nothing inherently wrong with that, right? If you've got the money, go to the Super Bowl if that's what you want. Now, it is one of the most expensive sporting events, hell, one of the most expensive events in general on the planet. So it is a little weird that somebody whose salary is $160,000 is able to pay tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars to take her family to this event, where not only were they in attendance, they were also in a luxury suite. They got on-field presence for Usher's halftime performance and had a bit of a meet and greet with players. Those experiences, according to estimates, can run you no less than $200,000 for a party of five, which is what Huckabee Sanders had. So the question is, of course, who paid for the trip? And Huckabee Sanders isn't saying a word about how she could afford such a luxurious vacation for her family. Not a peep. Voters want to know. People across the country want to know. How'd you pay for this? Just tell us. If you paid for it out of your pocket, great. No problem. Let's move on. But she won't answer, which likely means she didn't pay for it herself. And unfortunately, because of that law she signed, voters in the state don't get to find out who paid for this trip. But there is a bit of a tell. You see, Huckabee Sanders was actually photographed inside that luxury suite alongside, what is her name here? Tavia Hunt, a prominent GOP donor who is also the wife of Kansas City Chiefs co-owner Clark Hunt. So, if Sarah Huckabee Sanders had this trip paid for by a Republican donor and does not disclose it, that would be unlawful, first of all, for Federal Elections Commission and, of course, state disclosure laws. You have to do that. It could also be considered an illegal lobbying attempt. There's potential criminal activity that happened if Huckabee Sanders does not reveal who paid for this trip. This is not just, oh, she went to the Super Bowl and we don't know who paid. This is potentially criminal. This is, in my estimation, based on the evidence, this is likely criminal. So here again, we have a woman who initially tried to shield all her travel records when she first came into office. That's why she signed that law. So that was a scandal. The $19,000 lectern that she bought, that was a scandal. The Super Bowl, that's another scandal. Three major scandals in 14 months for this person who had never held an office a day in her life. The people of Arkansas, you know, a lot of people may think they don't deserve better, like you get what you vote for. But at this point, I still feel like they deserve better. They're being bamboozled by Sarah Huckabee Sanders. But at the moment, it doesn't even seem like they care. So maybe they do deserve it. I don't know. But for the rest of the country, we want answers. And we may even end up demanding a criminal investigation. Our sponsor today is Uplift Desk, creators of office furniture designed to help you work better and live healthier. If you sit all day long while you work and you've never tried a desk that can transition between sitting and standing, it's an absolute game changer. Studies have shown that using a standing desk can increase your energy, improve your mood and focus, boost productivity, and even lower your risk of disease. Build your dream desk by choosing from over 100 desktop choices and hundreds of desk accessories. And if you're planning on making the move this year to a desk that can transition between sitting and standing, then Uplift is the brand to pick. The Uplift Standing Desk has been chosen as Wirecutter's best standing desk for the past 4 years. You can choose three free desk accessories with the purchase of your standing desk. And
Uplift is more than just standing desks. They offer many other office furniture solutions, including conference and training tables, lounge furniture, office storage, acoustics, and seating. They let you build your custom dream desk by choosing from over 100 desktop choices and hundreds of accessories. The possibilities really are endless, and the products are absolutely top of the line. They also have free shipping and free returns with free shipping and an industry-leading 15-year warranty. Now, I recently made the switch to Uplift for my home studio, and I absolutely love it. It gives me the freedom to record while sitting down and then stand up when I'm off camera to avoid staying in the same position for too long. I also got a few file cabinets that match the desk to store all of my extra equipment so that my office is less cluttered and more functional. And being able to transition between sitting and standing gives me a whole new way to present videos if I choose to do so. And it really is as simple as pressing a button to make the desk go up or down. My Uplift desk is sturdy, and assembly was a breeze. My wife and I were able to assemble the desk and filing cabinets in no time at all. So if you're ready to make the switch to a desk that can transition between sitting and standing, head to upliftdesk.com/ROF and use code ROF at checkout to get 5% off your order. That's upliftdesk.com/ROF, or click the link in the video description below and use the code ROF at checkout to get 5% off your order.